Well, there's two A's and one person left who's the name. Oh, you're two people start with A.
Oh,
and one
person. Just Gen B then.
Yeah.
Gen B?
I wouldn't use that logic, but I'm okay with Gen B. I think you can do it.
Three, two, one, go!
Woo!
You're 15 seconds, Jen.
Yeah, making good time.
Got it, you're doing great. Awesome, you got it.
Go, Jen.
Get up. All right, Jen. You got it, you're doing great.
You're at 45 seconds, Jen.
30 seconds, you can make it, you can make it.
Go, Jen.
Sorry, Jen.
She did really try and challenge. I mean, I don't know if she was. I know she didn't complete the challenge, but she was like right near the top, and she was really trying.
So for this last one, you've chosen Anne and Abdel,
mm-hmm.
And Jesse will explain it.
It's the two-person low bridge right here. What's required is that one climber climbs up the pole here, gets onto the low bridge. The other climber goes up the ladder there and gets onto the low bridge.
And they meet in the middle.
And then the two of them walk towards each other. They meet in the middle. They work together to pass each other and then go to the opposite sides. Now they will have a couple of white ropes to hang on to that will help them, that will move with them.
Okay. All right.
However, they're going to be blindfolded when they do this.
Okay.
Right now my biggest suspicion is that Abdel is the mole because I know him in school and he was never really that quiet, and lately he's just been really quiet.
Guys, let me know when
the people are ready to go, Anne. Abdel, you're looking sharp.
Okay, congratulations, team. You did very well in this task. You got 5 out of 8 attempts successfully.
Right. That's pretty good. That's more than
are you guys interested to find out how much each of those were worth?
Yes.
Yeah. All
right. Well, Ian and Leo bet on the success of these tests, and we'll start with the first one. The first test was Jen Carey and Kelly.
Oh, no.
They successfully completed it, and it was worth $20. The next one I'll skip for a moment. I'll go to Ian and John Michael. They did the high bridge, and their attempt was worth $10, and they successfully completed it. Congratulations.
Way to go, Ian.
Next was Nori with the firecracker. Unfortunately, he was not able to complete that one, and that was worth $10.
It's okay. Nice effort.
Derek then did the Burma Bridge, and that one was worth $5. Unfortunately, he was not able to complete that one. The Leap of Faith was Lydia, and she successfully completed that. That was worth $15. Congratulations.
Ooh, yeah.
And the Eagle's Nest, Jen Brisman, unfortunately she was not able to complete that in time. Lucky for the group, that was worth no money.
Yeah!
Wasn't you, so.
And Ann and Abdel went at the end, and they pushed through their fears and completed that. Unfortunately for the team, not worth any money. Sorry,
Ann.
Now, I want to go back for a second to Leo's task. Leo had to climb up this tube, and Leo and Ian bet $20 on Leo to successfully complete that task.
Yeah, good job.
However, before the task began, because Leo had the highest, because Leo's task was worth the highest amount as an individual, do you want to tell them what I told you, Leo?
You told me I could get an exemption.
I told Leo that if he successfully got to the top, but didn't go over the edge and actually stood there and waited until the end of the 2 minutes was up, they would lose the $20 and he would gain an exemption. Leo refused my offer. He completed the task in record time and he put $20 into the pot, which brings your grand total to a $65.
Yeah.
Out of a possible 120.
All
right, so congratulations on that. You guys did very well in that last mission, and I bet you guys are all ready to get going out of this place.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yeah.
All right, then let's get out of here. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Dollar Point Lake Tahoe, a place that will soon be worth its name. If you guys would follow me inside, we have a special message from a very special person. If you guys will follow me in.
Here we go.
Come on in, take a seat on the couch. If there's not space, you can sit on the ground in front.
Oh my God.
Are you serious?
No way.
Oh my God.
If you guys can come sit over here.
Right?
It's Will.
Way to make him feel important.
Hi.
Guys, oh my God. Guys, this is Bill McDaniel.
Hey,
he was the mole on season 2 of the U.S. Mole. He is also a retired Rear Navy Admiral.
That's so sick.
And he has agreed to join us today and give you guys a special message and talk to you guys for a bit. So, Bill, would you like to say something?
Oh, well, hello. I got to tell you, when Adam contacted me a month or so ago and said y'all were doing this, I was thrilled. Who is Lalo and Ian?
It's good.
Ian, right here.
Yeah, y'all are the leaders.
Yes, we are.
Exactly.
Yeah, well, good. So sometimes, if you have a mole as a leader, and who knows, y'all may have a mole as a leader there.
Possible.
Sometimes you don't win all the games, and I understand that you failed in the lava game today. Derek, hold your hand up.
That's me.
Derek?
Yeah, Derek's right in front.
You're not great on monkey bars, is that right?
No, I'm not.
Monkey bars are stressful.
Not so much.
And Jen B.
Jen B's right on the couch.
Jen?
Right here,
so you
can
go forward.
Right here.
You look like an athlete. I figured you could climb trees, surely.
I was so close. You have no idea. You should have seen it.
Yeah, she was.
Yeah.
Nori, where's Nori?
Nori's hiding in the back.
Oh, where's Nori?
Thanks for pushing me.
Just want to make sure you got up there.
Nori, what happened with the firecracker?
I just got tangled and I couldn't pull myself up and stuff.
Yeah.
It is a lot. We'll check with you.